could be one. Looks like I got everything I need. Time to head back.
This is rather unexpected. I've managed to detect what seems to be part of an audio file. Let's hear it.
He saw something impossible. What do you think that could be?
I don't suppose it could be darkness of some sort. Perhaps it was the unseen chaos that supposedly sealed beneath Etro's temple.
Who could he have meant by the woman? You don't suppose that could have been the goddess? That doesn't seem possible, but...
The goddess? No, I don't think so. That would defy science. It was probably just the pilot seeing his wife's face flash before his eyes before he died. But what's that saying? Never say never. In order to produce a scientific explanation, we need to keep gathering more data.
Still got a long way to go.
Yes, but thanks to you, we're already a step closer. A little progress is better than no progress at all.
I would say you're right.
Things have been stagnant for a long, long time, as you know. That tiny bit of new information is an amazing discovery for researchers everywhere. You can't imagine the great gift you've given us all.
Well, it wasn't all thanks to me.
once you collect everything.
Whatever you're willing to sell. Here's your cut. Go on. Oh, I almost forgot. The boss wants you to have this.
You can make everyone's wishes come true. Choco Fogo! Thank you so much. For my friend, here's what I promised you. A soul fragment, just like we talked about.
I thought you said it wasn't an item. And that's why you couldn't give it to Saz yourself, right?
Kind of. It's something that's in my heart. Here, I'll take it out for you right now. Give me a second here. Here it is! One freshly baked smile fragment just for you!
I'm just relieved it doesn't smell like anything.
No, thank you! I hope I've helped pay him back for everything he's done for me.
Pay him back for what? Now would be as good a time as any to tell me who you really are. How do you know Saz and Daj? And just exactly how did you end up with one of Daj's soul fragments inside you?
That's still a secret for me to know and you to find out! Remember, once you have all five fragments, give them to Saz, okay? And of course, I'll be there to witness everything. I promise. Chocoboco later!
think that things are beginning to come into focus. So Saz is looking for fragments of Dodge's soul. And one of the fragments he's supposed to find is Dodge's smile.
A smile, huh? I'd like to see both of them do that again someday.
Yeah, I haven't seen Saz smile once since you met him here. Never mind smiling. He'll barely talk to you.
I don't blame him. Not with Dodge the way he is. The Saz that I remember. The worse the situation, the more he'd joke about it. He was a great friend when you were in trouble. But he's different now. We all have our limits, and he's reached his. He even lost his favorite chocobo chick. He doesn't have anyone left. To the goddess of death, these numbers I say.
Welcome, child. You may enter.
We're in at last.
Right. It's time to put an end to the freak show.
Promised time is upon us.
The promised time is upon us!
Behold the harbinger of destruction.
Behold the harbinger of destruction!
Return to chaos, our mother.
Return to chaos, our mother!
The time has come. Wicked savior, go now to Atrocide.
Death to the savior!
I'd introduce myself, but I'm guessing that you already know who I am.
She has come at last. It's the God Savior.
Kill her! She cannot live!
You're late, Hunter.
It's the Hunter, just as the prophecy foretold.
And
answer our prayers and slay the Savior! Make the Oracle true!
You murder innocent people and expect me to do your bidding?
But Hunter, you know we did it for you, for the prophecy.
Having a falling out?
Don't insult me, Lightning. You think I'm with these guys? Fanatics with blood on their hands?
He's working with the Savior. Kill them all!
Yeah.
These fanatics have been waiting for you, Noel. They think the Shadow Hunter belongs to them. But you were taking too long. So they panicked and started killing anyone who even looked like me!
Yeah? Then I shouldn't have waited, should I? I could have found you and saved their lives.
And now what? You're gonna fight me?
Yeah, that's right. That prophecy, it has to be true.
Has to be true? You mean I have to die? And you're the one who's gonna make it happen? Bring it on, Noel. I've been fighting destiny for a long time now, and I'm getting good at it.
Do you see them? Don't let them escape!
Light, the Salvation soldiers are here.
Lightning, follow me. We need to finish this, but it has to be the right place.
Come here around noon, I always see a man standing around lost in his own thoughts. He's always been a slightly odd character. He'll randomly burst out laughing. He just doesn't look like he's enjoying himself. Armand was mumbling something or another a few days ago. I think he was saying, it's time to say goodbye.
Is sealed tight. A perfect hideout for Herod.
Show me the crest of Etro. Hello, friend.
Yes.
Not you again. This is no place for kids.
Oh, I'm safe. The Children of Chaos, they look after me. If you ask me, you're the one who doesn't belong. Is Noel that important that you chase him here?
We were on the same side once. Friends, I guess.
But that was such a long, long time ago. Do you think he's still your friend? See, there's only one person Noel ever truly loved, and she's long gone. The Children of Chaos told me the whole story. It's a sad but sweet tale of a proud hunter and his friend, a girl called Yule. Oh, poor Yule. She left a hole in his heart that just can't be filled. It's not surprising, though, considering that she died in his arms. In those last moments they had, she looked up and said to him, "Don't cry, Noel. We will meet again in the future." Like you'd believe that, right? But Yule was a seeress who could see the future. Now, Noel knew that, so when she told him they would be reunited, what else could he do? He had to believe her. And so, he's been waiting ever since. The poor, sad fool. Centuries and centuries of waiting. All on his own.
How could I have missed that? All this time, the one thing that's kept him going are his memories of Yule.
Oh no, not his memories. The promise of a future gave him hope. There's another oracle drive up ahead. When you see the prophecy, you'll understand. You'll see why.
Huh?
He wants you, Dad.
I've spotted Noel. I'm going after him.
Light, don't be too hasty. We know he's trying to draw you...
He has to be egging me on. Drawing me toward the killing ground. It's like he needs everything to be perfect. Everything to be just right for his prophesied set.
Don't make light of this. The prophecy is real enough. The moment you die, the world dies with you. You can't forget that.
Yeah. I'm gonna save Noel. Whether he... So this is the prophesied future. By killing the Savior, a brand new world will be born. Yule. So that's it. All this time, you've been dreaming of a new world where you're reunited with Yule.
It's no dream, Lightning. The future is right there in the Oracle Drive. If I kill the Savior, then the world will be reborn. And this time, it's going to happen like it's supposed to. It's going to work. I failed once before, long ago. But you know that story. I defeated a friend because I believed that would save everyone. Everything went wrong. Yes, I won our fight like I was supposed to. And then he died. But that just unleashed the chaos that's tearing this world apart. So yeah, I destroyed the world. It's a hell of a thing. Snow never blamed or judged me, though. And Hope tried to lead humanity in the fight against the chaos. Of course, I fought alongside them both. Damn it, but we were fools back then. We might as well have spat in the wind the good it did. I'd already signed the world's death warrant. 5 short centuries, that's all we had. And now even that's gone.
Noel, it wasn't your fault. It never was. If anyone's to blame, it's me.
Maybe you're right. But you know what? I don't think it even matters anymore. I'm only interested in creating a new future. That prophecy is the key to my dream. My dream of seeing Yule again. I'm going to make it happen. It's nothing personal, Lightning. I really wish the prophecy didn't show you dying. But it does, and I'm sorry, but I'm going to make it happen. 500 years ago, I committed the ultimate sin. One more death on my conscience won't do anything to me. It has to be done!
That all you've got?
Damn, that god of yours gave you some serious power.
I'd call it a mixed blessing. I'm more powerful than I ever was, but it came with a price. I'm not even sure if I'm human anymore.
Not human? What are you, Lightning?
I wish I knew. Believe me, I've taken a lot of lives, more than I can count. If I had any humanity left, I would have been crushed by the guilt by now. Do I look crushed to you? I am going to see Sarah again. I'm going to fight for as long as it takes, give whatever it takes, even if it's my humanity. But you're not like me, Noel. I know you're different, even if it's for the future, even if it's to see Yule again. You don't have it in you to kill me. You're still human. You killed a friend once, in order to save the world, and you can't do it again. Right? You know it's true. I can see it in your eyes.
You think you're safe from me? Sure about that?
No. But the clock is ticking on this world, and I've got things to do before time runs out. You don't want to get in my way, Noel. You might still have scruples, but I don't. Not anymore.
Damn it, Lightning! Is this all you are now?
That's right. To save Sarah, I'll throw everything else away. I'll even be God's little pawn. No one's gonna stop me from trying. Not even you. You wanna find Yule? Then find her in death!
Oh, I'll find her, all right. Count on it. But we'll both be alive. In a new future. In a new world that I'm gonna make happen with my own two hands! Even if it means destroying you!
To make the prophecy come true, you think you have to kill me. Thanks for waiting. Lightning strikes.
Thank you.
Your dream is over, Noel. Let it go. The Hunter has failed to kill the Savior. Your prophesied future won't come true. It's all over now.
You think I'll give up that easy, Savior? I'm not done yet. I am going to kill you.
Sure, do your worst. Yule's still waiting for you.
That's right, I'll do it for Yule's sake. Even if it means having your blood on my hands. I know if she was here, she'd try to stop me. She's gonna be disappointed as hell in me, at least for a while. But she'll get over it. And I need this future. It will be done!
Why didn't you do it?
Because Yule... She wouldn't... This isn't what she would want. She had the power to see into the future. Every terrible vision she saw, one after another, whittled her life away. She must have known all along when she would die, and how she would die. But even so, she never gave up hope. She didn't stop trying to make things better for all of us. She didn't stop smiling. Yet, what did I do? I saw one prophecy and I let it control me. I didn't try to fix anything, just try to kill you to make it come true. I can't do it. I wouldn't be able to look her in the eye if I did.
But you destroyed the machine.
Maybe that prophecy was my last chance to see Yule, but maybe it's better this way. Maybe it's better to never see her again than make more mistakes. Did you hear that? Yule! Say sorry, but I did try to kill you. I don't think a simple apology is going to cut it.
Even if I pushed you into it? You've had 5 long centuries to brood on what happened. And I come along and force you into a corner. Maybe I'm the one who should apologize, but Yule was right. You belong in the future, and I can take you there. You deserve a new beginning. In a new world.
A new world. So is your god building us a paradise?
Not exactly. It's just an ordinary place, with ordinary people, working hard together to make it as good as it can be.
Doesn't sound like the Shadow Hunter would be welcome there. Hey, but if I'm gonna get a second lease on life, maybe it's time I stopped living in the shadows. Right, Lightning?
gonna do that. I was sure he was about to kill you. Did you sense something?
I didn't know. I took a gamble on him and hoped he'd come up with the right answer. Lucky for us, he did. You seem a bit troubled.
Yes, it's true, I am, but I...
Fine. I wouldn't want to force you to talk.
My, oh... You are a rather frank one, aren't you, miss? It's not that I've been sworn to silence or anything. Quite the opposite. I feel like I've got to tell someone. Let me start from the beginning. I am Aramaya, one of the blessed members of the Order tasked with looking after Lady Vanille.
Did you say Vanille?
Yes. Our Lady Vanille, the one and only holy saint who has been gifted with the mysterious ability to hear the cries of the dead that are carried on the winds of chaos.
Vanille, the saint?
Yes. Well, the fact is that the Holy One is particularly attached to one particular belonging, a small stone that she always carries.
I'm guessing it's no regular piece of rock.
You're quite right. It seems like something very special. It reflects the light with a rainbow iridescence. But several days ago, that very stone was stolen by some reprehensible thief. Ever since its disappearance, the poor saint has hardly said a word. She's completely withdrawn.
She can't find the thief?
Find the thief? The holy saint? She cannot leave the cathedral. It is completely out of the question.
I see. So you keep your precious saint locked up like some sort of criminal or animal.
You say too much. Well, the only reason the saint is kept within the cathedral is for her own safety and protection.
She can't be trusted with herself?
Yes, that's it, exactly.
If what you say is true and she never leaves the cathedral, then only other Order members could have gotten to her.
You're suggesting that a member of the Order stole the saint's precious belonging? You could not be more wrong. It's impossible.
Then you admit others into the cathedral to see your saint, do you?
There is an outfit which is allowed to enter to make their deliveries, but... their staff always go through a thorough inspection. They couldn't even sneak out a pebble if they tried.
There's an exception to every rule. Where do I find them?
I wish I could tell you, but I don't know. I think they work out of the warehouse district.
The warehouse district, huh?
Oh, you are far too kind.
I hear rumors of the murder victims returning from the beyond. Apparitions go against the Order's beliefs.
Shadow Hunter has broken his long silence and returned once again. That is to say, if he's the real Hunter.
I can't just...
What's the story with the box?
Well, it was given to us by a customer, but they must have forgotten to address it.
Why don't you just give it back to that customer?
Well, that's where things get a bit sticky, you see? One of our new lads handled the package. Said some bigwig from the cathedral gave it to him.
From the cathedral, huh? Let me guess. That bigwig is tied to the saint somehow, aren't they?
How'd you know that? The new lad was delivering packages to the saint's quarters when he met this person. Never even got their name or anything. We've really stuck our foot in it now. The Order is one of our biggest customers. We can't go back and admit we took a package from someone there without checking it.
I may be able to help you out. I'm looking for something that was taken from the cathedral. I'd like to check that box. If it's there, I'll return it myself. I'll take full responsibility for it.
I'd love to let you take a look, but I haven't been able to get it open.
Fine, I can handle that.
Wait, what? Hold on, seriously? You're kidding, right?
No, not really.
Looks like there's a lot more to this than I know. If you don't mind, I'm just gonna look the other way on this one.
Could there be someone within the Order with a grudge against Vanille? Maybe I should talk to that woman from the Order again, Aramaya. She might be able to answer some questions.
The final bell tolls, the earth will be destroyed.
Hey, is this the stone that Vanille's missing?
Oh, this rainbow sparkle, this sheen. Yes, the saint will be thrilled to have it back, I'm sure.
I don't know how close you are with Vanille. But do you know why she cares so much about that particular stone?
I do. The saint confided the truth to me when it appeared lost forever. She told me that this stone, this very stone, was held clutched in her hand when she awoke from her crystal stasis 13 years ago. She claims this stone holds a special power. Every once in a very rare while, it shows a glimpse of the precious family who is lost to her now. I can tell she cares for them with all her heart.
Family. She must have meant Fang.
Oh my. You know of Lady Fang? Yes, it seems it was possible for the saint to sometimes get a glimpse of Lady Fang in the facets of that stone.
I can see why the stone meant so much to her. Tell Vanille I'm glad she has it back safe and sound.
Oh, I couldn't possibly give her that message. But you will have the chance to tell her yourself.
Huh?
The holy saint herself has expressed an interest in seeing you. And so I was asked to give you this. Here.
A key.
This is a copy of the key that unlocks the service entrance to the cathedral. The saint has no duties at this hour and should be found in her chambers. The gates are locked. But if you use that key that you have there...
Then... I'll be able to see Vanille.
Yes. Just thinking that I might get to see the Saint smile again fills my heart with nothing but joy and happiness. Lightning?
Long time no see, Vanille. You look well, and you haven't changed. You're just as I remember.
Me and everyone else. But you don't mean it like that, do you?
Vanille, we'd fought together once a long time ago. We were comrades in arms in a battle against gods who toyed with human destiny. And at the end of that battle, she sacrificed herself. She turned into a great crystal pillar, rising from the plains of Pulse, holding a world full of people safe in the sky.
But then 13 years ago, she came back.
You again?
Oh.
So you two know each other.
Oh yes, we've been together ever since I woke up.
Right, thick as thieves.
But Fang's not around.
Well, we woke up at the same time, and we were together for a while, but she left.
And you decided to stay behind under the protection of the Order? You must have a reason.
Uh-huh. There's something I have to do. It has to be me, and it has to happen right here.
There's a lot of chaos swirling around in here. I'd have thought the Order's cathedral at least would still be clear.
Yes, yes, I know. It hurts terribly. I understand. But it won't be long now. You'll be free soon.
Vanille, who are you talking to? What is this stuff?
A wind of sorrow, the lament of the dead. Can't you hear their voices? Lost souls crying out in pain and suffering.
You mean this wind is the dead?
Yeah, they've been drawn here, one after another. All the people who died after the chaos poured through the gate. They've been swallowed by the chaos, and now they're trapped inside. I can feel it. All their sadness, all their grief. They're swirling around me. Every single cry feels like a dagger. Right in my heart.
There must be so many millions of souls. And you feel all their pain? That can't be.
Our world is being destroyed. There's no place for them to come back to. And there's no way for them to be reborn anymore. So they're caught in the chaos with their pain. They just can't escape it.
The Order believes that the souls have to be saved from their sorrow. They say the only way to do that is to offer them oblivion. Fenil's job is to call them to her so that can happen.
All of those souls at the same time? But Fenil, will you be able to handle all that?
I don't have any choice.
Besides, if she doesn't, can you guess what will happen? This wind has been building for years. Layers of souls. A black hole of pain. Try and imagine how much energy is inside.
If it ever got out, all at once.
It'd be the end of this world, and the future as well.
Chaos infusion or something?
Yeah, but don't worry about it. I'm fine.
I'm glad to hear that. Oh, and Vanille was looking well. Don't you think so?
Hope, is it me or do you sound happy? Does someone have a little crush?
What are you talking about, Light? Of course not.
I heard an odd rumor about the Hunter of Light ridding the city of monsters.
Snow's palace. Perhaps you'd start by checking out the situation in the Augur's quarter.
Welcome to the Glittering City.
You want to get into the Augur's quarter? You can beg and plead to God, but you won't have a chance in hell.
Welcome to the only shop you'll ever need. Thanks for dropping in.
So, I was wondering, where do you want to go next?
Monsters!
Hey! You there!
You mean me?
I know your face. You're the one I've seen on the posters.
Oh no, you've seen through my elaborate disguise. Yes, I'm the savior, here to steal the soul from your precious patron. What are you waiting for? Arrest me and you'll probably get a raise.
Shut up! I don't need you to tell me how to do my job, you damn criminal!
Looks like provocation will work. Stop. Keep it up. chase you around, you might get cornered. Take the offensive and try to throw them into confusion.
Hello. Is it your first time in Yuuzhan?
Feelings?
She is armed and considered extremely dangerous.
Yes, you have come at the appointed time.
And just what makes you so sure that I'm the savior?
His eye sees the truth. We are alchemists who seek the ultimate truth of all things. He has used the alchemic arts on himself.
So, what do you want with me?
Listen to his oracle. Your true path as the savior is known.
An oracle? If you've got something to tell me, I'll listen. But I choose my own path.
Listen, Savior. I say to you that which I have seen. Tomorrow, when the sun hangs highest in the sky, you shall meet us in this place. The encounter is ordained.
Hope, what do you make of these so-called fortune tellers?
They don't speak very clearly or quickly. But I think what they basically said was, they want you to come back and see them again at noon tomorrow.
It's not much of an oracle. They're just telling me what to do. Well, I'll decide
tomorrow. I really want to see the play.
This is a broadcast from the Public Safety Office.
The mist clears, the cycle is complete.
A warrant has been issued for the arrest of the woman calling herself the Savior.
How good of you to come and visit our glittering city.
Extremely dangerous.
You know, the Augur's Quarter didn't always used to be sealed off.
If you don't have an ID, you're never getting into the Augur's Quarter. If you really want to see one of the shows they hold there, you don't have much choice but the tour guide. The tour guide sneaks groups of tourists in through the back route to see the show in the Augur's Quarter. Trust me, he's not that hard to find. In fact, he's about the easiest person to spot.
I think we've got it now. I know how to get you into that palace. The gate. If you don't have the proper ID, it'll be impossible. To get through the front gate.
There are a lot of popular attractions in the Augur's Quarter. People want to see them, and it looks like there's a back route that people without IDs can use to get inside.
Every night, there's a play put on in the Augur's Quarter to honor God, the Song of the Savior. It's very popular with tourists, but most visitors just can't get their hands on an ID, so they find another way to see it, from a pretty lofty perch.
Lofty? There's a monorail near the palace that the supply train runs on. Let me guess, the enterprising tourists sneak into the Augur's Quarter along that track. Right?
That's right. It's the back route we've been looking for. Of course, the crooks who run the tours will most likely have people watching the entrance. You should find that so-called tour guide right away and get the whole scoop.
Calling herself the Savior. She has rose-colored hair and is carrying an enormous weapon. Citizens are asked to report persons matching this description to the nearest security
office. We hold special performance.
Come on, open up already!
Palace guards are conducting a search for the intruder calling herself the Savior.
Hail there, my stylish lady! You're just dying to see this show, aren't you?
You can try to hide it, but I know what a woman wants.
Maybe. Maybe not. Either way, I don't have an ID to reach the theater.
No worries about that. I can get you a special ticket at a special price.
A ticket, huh?
Oh, you playing innocent? I'm sure you know about the sneaking in special. I help the poor visitors to our fair city, people who don't have the requisite IDs, to see our most famous sight, the show in our illustrious theater. And I'm the only option they've got.
So I buy a ticket and you get me in to see the show, and I've nothing to go on but your word.
My word is good, but I can't offer any guarantees. I mean, who knows if you'll make it back alive? That depends on Lady Luck. So put your trust in Fortuna and your money in my pocket.
Fine. But how about a few more details?
I knew you were up for it. All right. Let me explain to you the brilliance of my little tour, shall I? It starts next to the monorail track. You know, the one that carries supplies from the industrial area. Up on that track, you'll find some of the best views in the city. If you know where to look, that is. I can take you up on the track from the industrial area and get you set up all nice and comfy. A perch with a view. You'll be able to see the Augur's Quarter and the theater.
Sounds easy enough. So where does Lady Luck come into it?
Well, the tour's not without danger. The chaos infusions have been hitting the industrial area real hard these days. You might have to fight more than just desperate tourists on your way to the best seats. I don't guarantee your safe arrival or return. All I guarantee is I'm the only way in. Not that it looks like you have plans of actually sitting down and watching a thing, my lady.
What are you trying to say?
Nothing. None of my business to say where you might be going or who you might be going after. I'm sure the Savior plays her cards close to her chest.
Gee, was it the posters around town that tipped you off?
I could sell you out to the palace guard, you know, make a pretty profit. I guess you'll also have to depend on your luck to see that I don't just do that, hmm? Now, don't you feel like coughing up and buying a ticket to my tour? I'll even give you a special price, just for you.
If you want to betray me to the authorities, go ahead. But watch your back if you do.
Ooh, look out for the big bad savior! A ticket for one! Time's on the ticket, be in the industrial area by then or you'll miss your chance for the show. One of my helpers will be in front of the gate to the industrial area. Give them that ticket and they'll take real good care of you. You know the area, right? Past Central Avenue and then across the sand in the lower city. We leave on the dot, so don't you dawdle or you'll have to wait for the next tour. Thank you for your business, my good lady.
She has rose-colored hair and is carrying an enormous weapon. Citizens are asked to report persons matching this description to the nearest security.
Dear goddess, stop him!
making a triumphant return.
You again.
Wait, can you hear me? I'm getting your feelings.
Buzz off, Hope. He does like to talk, that one. But jeepers, that was some showdown. Didn't go like I thought.
How so?
Okay, pop quiz. You get a special treat if you can tell me who showed Noel the Oracle Drive recording.
I'm guessing you?
Boy, I really underestimated the Shadow Hunter. I never expected he'd sabotage the prophecy himself.
After you went to all that trouble to set it up, my heart bleeds for you.
Hey, don't get me wrong. I didn't want it to go down any more than you. I'm happy it didn't. The world in that prophecy wasn't real. It was just a pretty fake. Like this god of yours, Benevelza, you know he's not omniscient. There are some things even he can't see.
Things he can't see? Things like this?
Oh, you're sharp as a knife, aren't you? When did you get to know so much about things? Still, I wonder if God knows his servant has her own agenda.
You don't know what you're talking about.
How's life on the surface? Once upon a time, Noel was one of the leaders. He helped us in the struggle against the Chaos. When the Order took the reins of power, he went underground, but he didn't disappear. He worked from the shadows to help keep the peace.
If the prophecy in the Oracle Drive is true, then maybe I should have died. That would be the best if it brings out the best possible future for everyone.
I'm not so sure about that. The moment you die, you'll have failed in your mission as Savior. And that, in turn, means you could not save Noel's soul. What would happen to him then?
You're saying those images in the Oracle Drive weren't real? Those scenes where everyone looked so happy and safe? They were no more than just a pretty fake.
They were just pictures. There's no way to see into the hearts of the people you saw in them. That wasn't very nice, now was it? What you did to poor Mog? It looked like it hurt.
I couldn't help it. I just reacted out of instinct. I don't go in for people hugging me, or Moogles, even if I'm glad to see them.
I think you actually enjoyed the hug. You just lashed out to cover your embarrassment. Am I right?
Hope, you better drop it. You're treading on dangerous ground now. It was Yule who told me. I knew there was something about that chocobo from the moment I first met him. Turns out Odin was reincarnated as the Angel of Valhalla just to help me again.
Reincarnation? I wonder, can creatures with souls choose to be reborn? Can they choose when and where? Or is it all up to fate?
Odin finding me was no coincidence, and I believe Sarah will be reborn and that we'll meet again when she is. Even if I can't see her now or talk to her, I know she wants to see me again. She has to.
Vanille and Fang turned into a giant crystal pillar, and together they held up an entire world. We were all supposed to be in it together, but in the end, the entire burden fell on their shoulders. So you see, they have to be helped. We don't have any choice. We owe them.